Especially if you all make randomly generated characters.
And we're live. Yes.
Good morning, America.
Good morning, Vietnam. Good morning, Vietnam.
I'm quickly going to set myself a reminder for tomorrow to harass you about the paladin feed again.
Thank you. Thank you. Should have done this 2 weeks ago, but hey, it is what it is. But yeah,
I was busy all week, for fuck's sake.
I know, so was I, man. Fucking hammer with the wing is
tomorrow, 1 a.m. or 1 p.m., you choose.
After session, no, fuck you.
Wait. Immediately after session.
Shut up, no. Maybe I'll do it after session if I'm not feeling tired enough. Cause
yeah, is Britt actually here, or did Nathan just drag them in?
No, Britt is here.
Sorry, what?
What do you
Britt?
Mean?
Britt? Hello, Britt? What?
Yeah, no, I'm here. Yeah, I've just been muted.
Been here for a few minutes.
Okay, I have a simple question, the same question I ask every single fucking week. And that is, are you ready to begin? And boom. Very cool.
I think we are.
Yeah, let's go.
So in that case, let's see if the bot will work, please. Last week it wasn't. Or actually...
Okay.
So, last we fucking left off on your little cool journey. I guess a lot of mourning has transpired. The will has been found for Baron. Which, of course, you read it. Yes, nice, the pot is working. And you did recover Sergal from Olash with a +1 of Tella. And basically, all of you... Sergal got back. You essentially gathered the ashes of Farron, found his will, read the will, and made promises, I guess. And then you took a long rest. And then, in the long rest, you met with a creature of the Fae. Unusual sorts, which proclaimed that your friend, brother, Karak, is doing something great somewhere out there in the Feywild, and that he may return to you soon. with that being said, you took a long rest afterwards, and it's up to you really to decide what you want to do, because technically it is day three. Like, since you got the keep, technically. So, who wants to go? Who wants to begin?
I'd want to do something.
Sure, let's go. Let's...
Well, I'm going to let the smoke rise a bit from my greenhouse as I water my plants.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, I will think to myself new ways that I could really function in the group. As the defense is almost overtaken completely by the others with their newfound strength, and I do say almost completely, I think of myself possible tactics I could include to better protect mine brothers. So basically it's a calm morning of strategizing and of another side activity.
I'm just seeing that mental image of you just calmly watering like some potted plants and like slaughter, manslaughter, war crimes.
Maybe I should get it.
Artillery.
Maybe I should get two shields the size of gates.
Scorch Earth tactic.
Salt the grounds you leave behind.
Mm-hmm. So, with that being said and done, What would the rest of you be doing?
Repeating my usual question, what is the cat doing?
A cat is missing from the pew.
For fuck's sake.
Start running around.
I assume the first person. I think the first person you would go to is, of course, your courteous steward, the pseudo dragon Karas, right? Ask where the cat went. Which he would gladly answer you that the cat went outside. Albeit, she is slightly above ground. She's on the mountain that the keep is under, and of course, he's alive.
Good to know. Going outside, following her, I would use my greatest deed to actually ascend the mountain.
You really don't need to even get out to cast the great seed. You go out, you look around just to see, you scan the mountain head, and literally 20 feet away by the mountain, about 30 feet up, you see her. But as they basically sitting on a more less intrusive mountain, more smoother side of it, and just seemingly just enjoying the sun rays of an early morning.
Just to be entirely sure, looking around, using a divine sense, are there any present threats nearby? Like something watching from the tree line?
No. There is sadly not.
Very well. If I were Lecter, I would leave my drone nearby, but sadly that's not an option yet. Guess I'll head back inside and go search for Brit.
What would anybody else do?
Yeah, I'd like to check in on our little dragon buddy and see what the progress is on the other vaults.
Oh, right. The vaults. So, it would like to give you some good news and bad news. Vaults 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10 are empty. The good news is the rest of the vaults had stuff. When it said had, they were, how do I say this? You essentially, when the Pseudo Dragon tries to make like a, I guess a sentence, all of a sudden just plops out a small box out of nowhere below the little post that his whole nest is. And the box is open and there is pieces of parchment that are basically, looks like within a piece of like touch that the like it would just evaporate. You know, maybe just a perception check.
Right as you asked that, my computer decided to refresh.
Ooh, okay. So what you can clearly see is it's very odd looking piece of papers in the box. The box is pretty simple. The papers are basically almost grayish and dusted, almost like there's a layer of dust. And then you realize that they're not exactly laying in the box, more like afloat. And with your passive insight, you realize that whatever transpired to these pieces of papers, Karas has preserved them with some sort of magic from falling apart. So whatever is you're seeing is being held by Karas's magic or some sort of will of his. But looking at the pieces of paper, literally every single one of them, you could see resemblances of ink and whatnot. But everything looks like second and about to break and apart into thousand pieces of crap, just pieces of barely feasible paper, just kind of held in place. If there's any way to restore it, this paper, you might seek someone out, but as they are in this state, they're unreadable and not really mendable by any means. As Kara just looks at the like, there's about 12 pieces of paper there. There's no descript, or I guess categorizing of from which vault what came. Because he didn't really ask. Or I guess Perrin didn't really ask. And, yeah.
Alright. Definitely keep this around. Don't let those fall apart. We need to figure out how to restore these. I'll send a message to Britt, because she's the smart one here. Britt, could you come here real quick?
Yeah, I'll be there in just a moment. And, unless Nathan gets to me first, I guess I'll head on over there.
I would say we meet in the floor, like somewhere in the hallways. And seeing you rush in one direction, I would just follow you behind.
I'm gonna say, oh, by the way, how's our cat friend?
Enjoying the sunrise up above.
And you're not up there with her?
There's a continuous, more pressing matter.
Fair enough, but don't let her linger too much without you there. Even if it's just being there. Even if just being near each other is an can sometimes just be enough. Anyways, I'm off to see what Chadwick needs.
I mean, that's the way to the exit for me as well, so...
Mm-hmm. Alright, so... I'm gonna eventually get to Chadwick. Alright, Chadwick, what you got for me?
Alright, so, first off, I found out there's actually more stuff for us to find in vaults 3, 9, 11, and 12, but I'll point down at the box. I have a feeling there's some important information in there. I don't know how to fix this.
You said, well, let's first, the vaults. You said, which ones are them? I'll have stuff in them?
Supposedly vaults 3, 9, 11, and 12, I think it was.
Which is the one we opened? Which is the one we opened?
7th.
We opened 7.
We opened 7.
Yeah.
Hmm. She's gonna think long and hard. It's like, Nathan.
Hmm?
Do you remember which of the vigilants we've already met?
The second? The fourth? I remember Farron was fighting some of them to even earn the right to this keep, so I believe it was the first? God help me on the rest. At least the first, the second, and the fourth.
Second. Well, that kind of defeats the theory that I had then. Unless this is a different order, you might want to go and see where the rest of the vigilants are at some point then, though. True. But anyways, about the box, you're saying that it might hold it?
Mind if I take a look at those?
Basically, there's no objection, but what you grab is...
I don't grab it, I take a look at it for now.
Like... Yeah, essentially, these are like... What is this? You know, have you ever seen like a slow-mo capture of like a fruit getting obliterated by a gun, right?
Mm.
And there's like a frame where it's almost everything scatters into pieces. It's basically that with a piece of paper as it tried to disintegrate into dust almost magically. But from Karras's, whatever the fuck he did, at the point of destruction, that's where the notes are kept. And it's illegible, you cannot read them. You can see that it's paper, and it had ink or some writing on it. But what, basically?
This is probably an incredibly far call. But Nathan has proficiency in calligrapher's tools. Knows a lot about writing because he's spent a ridiculous amount of time in the library.
Yeah.
Would there be any way for him to try to reconstruct what was written on those pages?
Roll me, but a simple history check with advantage, because you have proficiency with the...
I have proficiency in history anyway, so...
Okay, 33. Oh my fucking god. Okay, so, like in many avenues of many professions, cartography being not
calligraphy.
Calligraphy not being one without this rule, there have been made spells, enchantments to aid. Well, it's all sorts of endeavors. You know, while this being a niche spell, there have been spells that their sole purpose is to be used to reconstruct texts that are essentially beyond repair in any regular means, which would be these 12 pieces of paper as the prime example. The scroll of Textorum Reconstorum is an odd piece of scripture, a spell, that only a handful of people know, because, you know, it's a very niche thing, and it costs about 20 gold pieces, as you remember. You assume if you go to Olash, or maybe even just ask Leo about you can find a scroll for it, because it can't really be a spell. You probably could just restore it by using up scrolls.
Okay. I mean, this is... Nathan just, like, tilts his head towards this. this is beyond saving. But this isn't the first time stuff like this happened. There have been ways to remake this. You could probably ask some scribes to get you spell scrolls to repair that. Get something like that in Olash, or ask a powerful mage.
Yeah, what happened to the old guy? The wizard you saved.
Very right. I'm casting, going to take out my sending stone. Leo, do you happen to have or know where to get the scrolls of Textorum Reconstructor?
You get a message in your head almost instantly. Do you know about these? What? Okay, okay.
Nathan just like kind of tilts down his ears a tiny bit, like a combination of embarrassed and just grinning.
How many do you need?
Do you want all of these repaired?
I mean, what, there's 12 pieces of paper there. They probably all have important information on them, don't they? I don't know.
One word message back to Leo, 12.
You get an almost instant response. I have two by hand, as every good wizard should. I could make four in like 1 hour. And then I would need some materials, would take me about 2 more hours. And then after 6 hours in total, I could get you all 12. Albeit you have 300 gold pieces, I know where we can get at least 15 of them. I'm not spending my money. Hmm? Just saying.
I would convey this information to Chadwick and Brit.
Yeah.
300 gold pieces for 15.
Most of my money I kind of gave to Baron, but I got 73 gold on me. And I'll hand it over.
You must have forgot you had raided a golden red dragon.
That's the problem. The person who's in charge of the finances is dead.
Which one of you is going to be the new financial guide?
We don't have the logistic sheet yet.
Oh. I thought he gave you all the statistical sheets.
Rough no. week.
No. Oh, no.
Sadly, he died with the ledger.
No.
Please no. Please no.
I shall assume.
Sorry, how much did you? How many did you have?
I had 73 gold on me.
73. Okay. Okay. Very well then. The Horde shall pay for the rest, and I will update those notes accordingly later.
Okay.
I'll keep track of it.
Okay. Okay. So. As you say, you have the goal, Leo, after a few minutes, presents himself in front, basically finding you, asks for the gold you give him, and he says that it will take about half an hour.
He's just gonna buy these, isn't he?
Maybe, but as soon as he said that, he vanishes. Just gone.
As long as they work, I don't care where he gets them from. I have a way. Brit? Keep in mind, we still have a service to carry out.
That we do.
And with that, I'm going to go outside.
Sir, what are you gonna do?
Well, Sergal is a little slow to get out of his bed. First thing he does is he knocks on Tella's door, like, seeing if she's still in there.
Yeah, she's asleep.
Ah. I'll leave her to it and go search out breakfast. Sergal doesn't have much in the way of, like, a plan yet. And honestly, probably if and when he sees Dagger, he wants to talk to him. So where would you be at, Dagger?
Dagger.
Not here, apparently.
Yeah, no, I'm here. I forgot to put down my microphone. Okay, so at this time, I'd still be around the... I'd still be in the greenhouse doing my thing.
Ah, well. Then Sergal would just eat breakfast and... People watch.
People watch. Very cool. So,
proceeding on, I guess.
Yeah, proceeding, yeah.
Is there an actual path that leads up the mountain, or is it just rough climbing?
It is literally this entire old castle, whatever you want to call it. Is basically looks like a mountain just was placed on top of it, and through how long of the time greenery has taken over it.
So literally the cliche of like a dirt mountain on top of the fortress,
kinda. Yeah, but also now that you look eastward, you can basically see a path that is being still cleared, because remember, you got yourself the road clearing.
Yeah, following up that path, roughly going to where... the cat currently is.
You just still don't
it's
know
still
her
awkward
name.
That we still don't know her name, and it's no. Honestly super funny to me.
You're never gonna know, you're just gonna go for all the romance options, but no fucking name asking.
And then at marriage, what's your name?
No.
Wish to marry.
I'm really sorry. It may be a little much, but we do need your name for the marriage certificate.
Yeah.
Honestly, I think it'd be more insulting not to ask.
Honestly, it's kind of funny that we still haven't asked. Anyway.
Anyway. Anyway, indeed. So, yeah, it's an easy, simple climb. It takes you less than a minute, and you're basically, yeah, it is kind of the stagnant dirt that is basically set, and the roots are keeping you don't slide off with the grass. But yeah, you come with contact with the cat. The cat seemingly staring at a nice rolling clouds in the sky, kind of carelessly staring at them, and eventually her eyes shift and just look at your face. Anything you wish to say?
He would, after being acknowledged, just sit down next to her. Also look up into the sky, with the irony of the blindfold, and just honestly ask, are you enjoying the view?
It's good. Pleasant. It is different, But in a good way.
From what?
There is no purpose to me. But there is also freedom. I am currently plagued with indecisiveness of what to do. But for now, I'm enjoying the little things. The little things that I did not enjoy previously.
Guess some of us still need to learn from you. I mean, we are following the same path. Not quite sure where we're supposed to go. Yet here we are.
She finally turns her head slowly towards you and just asks, why did you do that? You had no certainty, you had no plan. Clearly.
Which part? Cutting you off or resurrecting you?
Let's go with cutting off.
Honestly, I really need to apologize for that. I somehow it was clear that you suffered from it. There was something about it that you didn't enjoy. And I failed to see the second half of it.
How many aspects of the Paladin, truly? Do you enjoy the killing? Do you enjoy the Tyrus walking? Do you enjoy looking around, making sure that nobody's gonna stab you in the back? Do you enjoy
the third of those, mostly. It is the O5's one, after all. If you're looking for exercise, well, I'm afraid he came a bit too late.
I am not looking for exercise. I'm just... He seems to be lost a bit again, looking at the sky. I guess I am enjoying myself in the moment. There's just awkward. Sorry. I know.
No. I just had this horrible image in my head. You know that meme with like the guys winning the flower smelling contest?
Oh. Oh no.
I'm just seeing that image. If I were to tell Farron from beyond the grave that we're literally just taking a moment to enjoy the scenery, he would like, you're not enjoying it hard enough.
Take so well.
Oh. And competitive enjoyment.
Oh, you know, that would be fair. It's not really enjoying the environment if you don't really get the pollen up your nostrils.
You see, the trick is to really stuff it in there.
If you don't leave with flower petals in your mustache.
But I don't have a mustache. That's your problem.
And nectar in your sinuses. You're doing it wrong.
Exactly.
Anyway, sorry. I just completely derailed the conversation. Nathan, what I should have noted, Nathan has not been wearing his helmet for the entire time. That's just been strapped to the belt. And in the context of what he said about literally just relaxing and appreciating the moment, Nathan will take off like the gloves and like loosen some of the armor that he's been wearing. He's wearing plain clothes under that, so just
calm. So you're just gonna sit there with her, not even gonna ask her name. You're just gonna stare at the sky.
It's not a question that is relevant. You don't need to know someone's name to enjoy time with them.
True.
Anybody remember?
Nathan, you better never learn her name in the entire course of the campaign. So help me.
Hey, Araxis.
do you
know that one meme? What is a skeleton's favorite snack?
Oh,
in
this
case, what is this? What is the cat's name? Come on, ask. Come on, ask. What are you doing? Why must you fail me so often?
Literally.
What's the cat's name? Yeah.
I wanted to say something so bad just now. Ooh.
You a coward.
No,
do
fuck
it.
You. This is my stream. Do it on your own fucking stream, smiley face. Anybody else? Because, you know, morning. I guess Circle eating breakfast, Chadwick, is... I don't know. Bread Chadwick.
After... I guess I'll be praying.
yes, I know, but Chadwick Bread.
Yeah. Well, since Baron's not here anymore, I still need a trading partner. Yeah, Britt, you wanna spar for a bit?
Sure.
Oh, but when I want to spar...
You did.
When?
Yeah, we did.
What? Oh, right, that was important, right.
So, you know what I'm going to do now? Because I really, really know how this is going to go if I do not have this intervention. So, my good people, like I did so on a previous campaign in Dark Valley, I'm going to do this... I'm gonna force time skip.
Okay.
Every single one of you, unless you wish to do a final thing for, what's it called? For Farron now, or you want to wait for opportunity? You have the ashes secured. You do not need to rush it.
Actually, how much time do we have again?
Three weeks? Yes. So
that's wonderful stream. Okay.
You know, I should have gone on the journey. Damn.
From the beginning, as the first order was set by Farron, Icarus, a week went by. As slowly but surely, you gained a road out to the east. The trees fell. Now, on top of, you know, having a road that is clean and fresh and brand new, you also have an insane amount of lumber at your disposal. Do as ever you wish. For everybody else, they have set in nicely, all of your companions. Albeit, you know, they are not very keen on fighting, except for one individual, Arthur, of all people. Unbeknownst to all of you, he, in a matter of a day, out of nowhere, came seven individuals from the Coalition lands, from Norn, or I guess used to be Norn citizens. Four dwarves, three humans. And I'm gonna just get their names in so you can... Uh,
fun would it be to have turrets on the castle, like on the castle's edge? Automated turrets.
Arthur's gonna turn into TF2 engineer.
So, on the end of the first week, not only did you essentially got a road clear, a shit ton of supplies of wood, you also have 7 engineers, gunsmiths and of highest caliber, the cream of the crop of the Kingdom of Norn when it was still relevant and powerful in some means. I guess Arthur would like to introduce each and every one of you to them. As they, basically, Arthur, with the help of Liam, essentially summoned them all in a moment's notice, as apparently it's supposed to have been a few days prior, but some hiccups occurred in the collision side. The details, of course, were not told to you, but of course you can ask. So,
honestly, I would.
I mean, yeah, you would. But I guess now is the time to ask, as you essentially. So,
if there was holdup, what was that to worry about?
But yeah, every one of them looks basically like Arthur. Plain, not like Arthur, like similar clothed. Bland, brownish clothing, a bunch of tools, a bunch of oil under their, Argastar under their fingernails. You know, engineers, mechanics, and other stuff. And by the look of it, a dwarf by the name of Runt, an elderly man, an elderly dwarf in his 70s or 80s by the looks of it, while looking like he's about to fall over on the slightest breeze of the wind, has incredible fervor. As basically you're getting called down, he immediately runs to each one of you and essentially gives a far, firm handshake to each all of you, introducing himself as Runt. Like, Runt, nice to meet you. Runt, nice to meet you.
Nathan, wonderful.
Nodding, keep nodding, keep nodding. And as I guess you all get introduced with the new 7, Runt, before Arthur even makes like a announcement or more like a what are we gonna do, Runt almost takes the show from him and just goes, right, one of you needs guns. I was informed. Big guns. And he kind of points at every one of you, trying to kind of like almost aim to figure out which one is it. Is anybody gonna say anything? Volunteer?
I'm just gonna look at my big axe, my +3 grade axe, and I'm gonna look at him and I'm gonna say, what can you make into guns?
Well, depends on the what exactly you're trying to dream of. Wait, you want me to stat points at your axe?
Asking if you could. It has magical properties.
Come here, give it over. He just extends his hands. Give me a second. I'm gonna find a quick. Oh, fuck it. Yeah, I found a good image for this. On the Runt's image. So, as he examines the gun, a few hushed whispers under his breath. I don't know, maybe. Then looks at you and says, I mean, I couldn't modify, but could attach something to it if you want.
As long as it makes damage, I suppose.
No creative response. You! Centaur, right? Points at you, Chadwick.
Yeah.
I was told you wanted platform. Who's the gunner?
Yeah, unfortunately, the
The gunner has passed away. But I know he was working with your man Arthur over there. He had a couple of blueprints going. Just continue on with those blueprints, I'm sure. He had other things in mind for me also.
That's fine, but who's going to be the gunner? Like, I understand you're going to be the thing, but who's going to, you know, he kind of gives this motion with his two thumbs and they do like a clicking motion to his fists.
I'll kind of look around. Anyone want to, anyone fire a big gun?
Are you asking someone of us to fire a gun off your back?
Without skipping.
That's what I'm offering.
Okay, this is run by the way. There you go. Have at it. but without skipping a beat. Give me a second. I'm gonna check if I can get it exactly. Without skipping a beat, a very familiar a very familiar red dragonborn lady takes steps forward.
The thrill of firing bitches love cannons.
I mean, who doesn't? as she of course gives a loud and raise her hand quite politely. Run examines her, looks at her a bit, looks at her physique, takes her head. Are you willing to squat for hours on end? Nora looks at the dwarf, then looks at you, Chadwick, with a smile.
I'll raise an eyebrow and smirk.
And then she looks back at the dwarf and says, I believe I can do a lot more things than just squat. The dwarf shakes his hand in a bit of a confusion and shrugs. Okay. I'll need to take some measurements. Arthur, Jeffrey, get some parchment going, and then looks at the rest of you. Okay, so, I'm sorry, I completely forgot, this is the fairyland, I forgot, this is the empire, you gotta be all majestical and magical. He takes a deep bow in front of all of you, almost as in a mocking way. I am Master Runt, apprentice to Master Merrick. Late Master Merrick. Second best gunsmith of all lands. Of Norn. But then I guess Kyrgnos as well. With the recent developments. If you wish to commission me, I was told you have ample of gold and finances and that you're paladins, yada yada yada. Tell me what you want. Long range, medium range, short range, and any specifics. Now, you don't need to answer it now, because I got my hands full, and points towards the centaur. But if you got any specifics, or maybe more mystical, inspired takes on what you wish in the terms of place of firing a bullet, or as I like calling, firing a very, very hot piece of rock, very, very fast. Please do not be shy. Arthur kind of like looks at Runt. Can everybody roll me an insight check?
What even is my inside right now? There it is.
I'll probably switch music. Oh, I mean, actually, it's not gonna fit.
Me and Sergio both got 15.
So.
Oh.
That's funny.
Brings the plus 16.
Nathan and Chadwick.
Listen,
baby.
Circle. It still goes past us by two. Okay.
Yeah, I know. I'm just lamenting the nat one.
So, as Britt, Chadwick, and Nathan, as Run mentioned that he was apprenticed to Master Merrick. Late Master Merrick, signifying that he has passed, you all of a sudden see a jolt on involuntary twitch in Arthur's face. You see immediate sadness and almost despair. Whoever Merrick was, Arthur looked up to him. Was he friends? Was he something, you know? Or he was just a figure that he, you know, looked upon, you don't know. But whatever Merrick was to Arthur, Arthur cared for him, and he said about the passing.
Well.
Welcome to the team, I guess.
Yep, I would like to formally welcome you to the team. Enjoy your stay here, and, if pleasant with pleasantries out of the way, let's get working. Get to it.
So, Chadwick, for one day, you're gonna be occupied. Essentially, you have been laid with a bunch of... You've been taking measurements by the eight people. Your size, your weight... your pressure with each hoof on the ground. How fast you can run, how fast you can turn. Everything has been taken by your, you know, what they ask of you, but also devices never seen or even heard. Trying to pronounce the devices would hurt anybody's tongue, unless they're of more scholarly types. But basically, good news. Whatever contraption, as at the moment, the run that uses the word contraption for your little project, Chadwick, will take about a week until it is complete. And basically, first day was basically measurements, and it's gonna be testing after a week, so I guess be prepared. Also, Nora had essentially the same amount of measurements from size, weight, to reaction timing, bone density, and maneuverability and flexibility of her said body. Also, a proposition came from Karis, because a week has passed, that you should act. You should make something more of the keep. You had a list. I hope any of you made a decision. It's been like...
I mean, I'd want to turn up the temperature down over there in the forge there. Chadwick would want to turn up the temperature of the forge, both in honor of my bestie who's passed and to help those little dragon buddies.
Would that help those little dragon buddy?
I don't know.
I mean,
they are red dragon egg. I mean, I'm sure it won't hurt them. But maybe there's like an ideal temperature. I don't know.
You know, there would be something I would ask of Arthur. If he had the free time within the big project.
Oh yeah, everybody has time. Every one of them has time, but you know they're mainly almost like following the lead of Runt and his commands. But clearly, since you're the people who are essentially got him lodgings, paying for their projects, they're more than obliged to listen to your ideas.
Wonder if they would be able to make me some some tools. If not, I'll go to the little dragon to ask if he can get some tools delivered.
What kind of tools?
Herbalism. Well, I'm not sure if a herbalism kit can be made, but an alchemist supplies. I guess I'd better go for the dragon, the pseudo dragon.
I mean, the mechanical half isn't difficult. Alembics, holders, spoons.
Tools of measurement, basically.
Oh, no, if you go to the people, the engineers have a shit ton of equipment. Like, they didn't bring, a chest with a bunch of... They have a shit ton of bag of holdings, though. They have more inventory than you had in the forge previously. And it's from basic measurements and scales and files to some complex enigmatic contraptions that kind of makes you kind of just think on what you're looking at. You can get any kit from them with ease by just asking. Albeit not immediately, but one bit by bit from several bags of holding, you can acquire everything you want.
All right, well, full kits of a full herbalism kit and alchemist supplies then.
Yes, please.
Okay. All right. Well, then I'm definitely going back to my greenhouse and I'm gonna start setting up some stuff.
I do have a simple question.
Yes.
Would you set up a green? Because there was no greenhouse, but I have a simple question. Did you set up a greenhouse outside?
Because
there's the mountain that you could, or you could go outside, literally outside.
Yeah, definitely, definitely just outside the castle.
Okay. There's no problem there. You do know. Or you notice dagger throughout the week. If there's any critters, all mice or whatnot, trying to get you or anything, they immediately get caught and eaten by Karas or one of its shadows.
I thank him every time.
Yeah. Anyway.
And I'm gonna start making some concoctions. I'm actually going to experiment and start learning true alchemy.
True alchemy. Oh yeah, by the way, for your little thing, dagger.
Yes.
Nothing happened. You don't even get to roll. Nothing.
All right.
You said it. Thing yes. Come forth. I do have the question for the rest of you. Right? Oh yeah, dagger.
Yeah.
You're trying to learn true alchemy in what way?
I'll try to make stuff that can actually help me get stronger in a way. I'll try to actually make buffing potions.
In that case, how long would you try to sway this? A week? Day?
As long as I can grow my ingredients, attempting all I can.
If you're gonna do it the week, give me free intelligence checks or nature checks. Your call with it then.
Okay. Nature checks or intelligence checks?
Yes. Yeah. Nevertheless, what is everybody else doing? Because the first week here, it's been calm. No problems. You have more than enough food for a very long time. And everybody's kind of settled in.
I'm going to go and talk with Arthur.
Mm-hmm.
About that insight check.
Double 19 for that one.
Ask him that I noticed that he there was sadness when that name was mentioned and was interested in why. Just tell me the story.
So Without like showing any big like you can clearly see from the get-go that he didn't personally know him.
Uh-huh.
But he had a lot of respect for him. As after some, I guess taking a few breaths, he tells you a tale of Gunmaster Mech, the grandfather of modern weaponry. He essentially made a revolutionary bounce in Norn by developing smokeless gunpowder, a pushback system for small and large caliber weapons, semi and automatic fire guns, invented several different leaps of artillery and tank development, and essentially he is regarded as a one of a kind, an intellect beyond reason who spur nation of Norn from essentially a very basic and almost defenseless pseudo nation to an actual kingdom because of this rapid ingenuity of his mind. By Nornian standards, by Norn, he by all means was regarded a hero, and he is a hero. But also he was a man of science, and everybody who respected science respected him. And it is kind of sad that he has passed.
I see. Take it in. It's like, well, at least he left a legacy.
You know, it's, that legacy is going to be built on your brother's back. It's not your brother, but you.
Well, known him long enough, he might as well be. There's a slight sadness in Britt's eyes about that. It's like, in any sense, if you ever require an extra hand and that, give me a ring. I'll always be there for you. Gives a wink.
No, it's... So... For the papers, that is a good question. So, 2 out of 12 papers were not. To quickly explain the scroll's ability, when it's used upon a piece of paper or tome or any significant bundle of pages bound together. Within a minute, they are essentially restored to the properties of its inception. As in, as soon as they were finished written by the author, that's the state they've been returned. 2 out of 12 pieces of paper just turned into paper. Blank sheets of perfectly good paper. Two others turn into what seems to be scribbles in common. Without much investigating, it's easy to see there was 2 attempts in making a love letter to a girl named Maria. The scribbles basically attempt to describe her as beautiful, insightful, and fierce. But the author's attentions, I guess he didn't like them. So basically scribbled them off and kind of just crumpled them. One... Oh no. One piece of paper immediately, Nathan, you realize is that of a scroll, of a spell scroll. A very detailed and very complex.
As an advisor?
No. Because you know, you would probably all be there when that happened. Yeah. But Leo, immediately seeing the scroll at the very, the formation, he snatched the piece of paper and stashed for himself. As you, of course, clearly would ask why he would do that, he would say that eventually he would tell you, but now is not the season. And if you try to clarify, is it the time? No, the season.
Which season is right, then?
The season would be jolly?
6 weeks, pronounced as simply. 6 weeks. I'll tell you. Everybody has agreement with that? Or
he seems honest about that, right?
Yes. I assume all of you would just look at him, trying to see him. He seems not fearful. He knows what he has in possession is powerful spell of sorts. But he really would like to just safekeep for the sole reason that it doesn't get lost. It's almost like finding a diamond in the dirt. And he's keen to sharing what the spell is, but it is not the time. For some reason.
Yeah, but he's willing to inform us what it is.
Yes, eventually. But when he says he's...
It has to age.
Yeah, it has to age.
It has to ferment.
Yes, it has to ferment. Okay, so... Okay, 2, 2, 2. Okay, one piece of paper is literally a list for a recipe of stew. Elk, onion, garlic, chicken bones, red berries, blackberries, salt, cinnamon, pepper, and a small instruction of how to properly prepare the meat, how to prepare the base for the stew, and how to cook it. By all means, you just got a recipe for a stew. Take it as you will.
Out of curiosity, what little information we have about local availabilities, would this be reproducible? Or replicable?
You know that they're wild game elk. Probably if you look around, it is the time where you could find some probably bushes with berries. Definitely red, black, you don't really know. You do have the herbs from Brit that you purchased. So, yeah, you could replicate it if you really wish. And it's literally just how to make the stew. There's no, like, a name for it or, like any content. It's, like, it is handwritten. It's not, like, a tear out of some book of recipes. It's literally just somebody wrote it.
Sweet.
One piece of paper is a report from Paladin K to Paladin M, as in their first letter of the name or maybe surname or something. As the report reads about everything being calm, still, and peaceful. Albeit too peaceful, and there is an urge to call upon tea. For tea knows when things get too calm, violence can escalate extremely fast. And nothing more of the context. If the second piece of paper fine, or I guess out of the 12, is actually a response that Paladin T is missing. Not that he escaped or went AWOL, but more that he went on one of his journeys and nobody really knows when he's gonna come back. But of course, the simple responses of doubling patrols and listening for the local folk if there's anything awry, any wives' tales of some recent spooks that happen, or some odd signs, bad omens, etc., etc. How many pages now? There is, I think, 8, right? 2, 1, 2. I think it's...
We should be at 8, yeah.
Yeah. 9 piece of paper is a calendar. A calendar for for the 5th era, year 257. And it is the month of summer. It's, you know, it's 3 months. It's a very primitive, blank calendar. It doesn't have any notes or scribbles or anything. And Leah would tell you that if there was anything left, you know, some additions, it would have most likely printed in spell. So whatever this piece of calendar meant, there's nothing was written on it. The 10th piece of paper is a poem dedicated to someone's beloved Maria. Where, from reference of the other two scrapped poems, this one... You have a choice now. Religion, Arcana, or History. All of you can choose one, and you can roll.
Arcana, History, and what other one?
Nature. No, religion, I'm sorry. Religion, Arcana, or History. You can choose one of them.
Religion, Arcana, or History?
Yes.
I love having fish.
But
you know what, Britt? Just take advantage. You have 5 times the modifier I do.
Jesus fucking Christ. Only...
Ouch.
Okay. It's the exact same one.
I'm not gonna recite the poem because I don't have it on hand, because, man, random stuff. But to put it simply, it is 12 verses, you know, 12 lines in 3 sections. And essentially each section praises Maria for her bravery, for cunning, for her warmth. And, you know, it's decently well done. You know, it's not super awe-inspiring, but, you know, it's a lovely token of love for this Marian question. However, Nathan, for you, just stare on this piece of paper. There's nothing magical about this. You know, it's not enchanted by magics or whatnot. And if it was enchanted...
Is it me, or is he cutting off?
Yeah, I am cutting off my PC.
Bit. I'm assuming it's my internet.
No, my PC is just having aneurysm. Don't worry about it.
Okay, just making sure.
Yeah. So basically, the poem is pretty simple, pretty nice. The piece of paper isn't magical. But But Nathan, you stare at this piece of paper and you cannot shake a feeling out of it. You don't know why. You don't know how. But you feel like this is an incantation. An incantation to summon a demon. An incantation to summon a demon, and Maria is being substituted. Being a substitute name for whatever it is. As all of a sudden you look at it and you kind of just realize that the bravery, the cunning, the warmth can very much easily translate to a being of demonic entity or a demonic origin. Can you roll me an insight with disadvantage?
Or guess, so equal roll
yes,
on my end.
Yes.
Insight. 23 still.
Perrin spoke to you about something happening here, something getting betrayed or whatnot. You assume that this Maria person was part of this little conspiracy. Maybe the reason why this whole thing was abandoned in the first place was because of this Maria. And now you're just staring at this paper and almost like there's nothing magical in it, right? But you just feel like this piece of paper leads to some dark road that turns someone's lives for fucking worse. You don't know how exactly, but you know it did.
Okay.
For the 11th piece of paper, it is actually not a letter, not a writing, but it is a drawing, a sketch, if you will. It is a simple sketch of a young man, human. Not by the looks of Terramach. Short hair, fair face, clean shaven, looks kind of happy, no signature or anything. If you want to roll history for it, you can.
Could you repeat that? You cut off.
Where?
If you want to.
Oh yeah, if you want to roll, if you want a real history for this, you can. For this.
Is that just me, or is it?
Yeah,
it's cutting out for me too.
My PC's having an aneurysm. Thank you very much. I know.
Okay, I assume history, religion, or economy.
No. History. Just history this time.
History.
Yes.
Okay, we're rolling history. Sorry.
Technically, everybody else can roll the history as well if you wanna, because, I mean, it's for all, but I don't think nobody's gonna beat Nathan's.
I mean, doesn't Brit have an equal intelligence score to me?
Brit has, yes. No, Brit has one less.
Also,
which still means Brit could roll higher than me.
Also,
oh yeah, easy.
Also, Brit is muted, so I don't know.
Brit, you get advantage.
I do have a +7 in intelligence, but I don't have proficiency in history. So,
I mean, it's your call. But yeah. Nevertheless,
did you get +13 in history?
Religion was the third. Oh wait, sorry, that was religion. Sorry.
Oh.
I spelled the wrong one. Anyway.
You know, this is a sketch of a young man that one day, or I guess back in the past, became the first vigilant. His name was Norris. And
Chuck Norris?
No, just no. N-O-R-I-S. No two R's like Chuck Norris. No. Just Norris. Just Norris. Also, yeah, Chuck's first name is Chuck, not Norris.
Chuck?
Yes, his last name is Chuck, spelled with two C's.
But yeah, you don't know how, when this sketch was made, but you can assume that it is at least 80 or even 90 years old. Because when the Vigilance formed, Norris was already in his 50s, 60s. So the young sketch is even, you know. And as for the final vault thing, it is a pentagram with demonic runes. Who can read demonic?
Abyssal or Infernal?
Oh, yes, man. I forgot Infernal. Why do I think of Pathfinder. Yes. Infernal will do fine.
All right.
It is...
That would be...
It is a simple instruction of how to prepare a demonic summoning circle. It requires 5 pints of blood for a square foot. Requires black ashen hair. It requires a lot of sickening things that you would need to kill several people, more specifically innocent people, to require its reagents to manifest a gateway. A portal for a being. What the being is dictated to be, or to whom this gate was meant to, there is no description for it.
I relay this information. It looks like the Vigilance would do a start by this.
So.
I just realized my microphone was up. Just a quick question as an interlude. Could I try to see if I can remember whether there ever were any Vigilants whose name began with K?
Ooh, I'd say with the 30. Yeah, so here's the thing, interesting thing about the Vigilants, right? Probably understood this. Vigilants, while a title is well heard in the Senator in the region, their names are not very disclosed. Close, as they were secretive. Taramak is probably one of the most known, because he didn't give a shit about stuff. A letter with K. That would be Kella. Kella is the fourth bit.
Okay.
No, fuck. No, fifth. I'm sorry, fifth. Fourth is, Man, I should... Man. Piece of paper. I need a piece of paper. The fifth Vigilant was a dwarven lady. Good with a war hammer, proficient with fire, and apparently rode a ram that was made of fire. That's pretty much how much you know with a 30.
Okay.
Oh yeah, by the way, I have a simple question. For the people with the improvements, I know that the fire is 5 days. Pick another thing that is 2 days, so we can skip to the next week. So, yeah.
The what now? Who now?
The forge improvements. We spent 5 days to power up the forge.
Yeah, so
by accounts of Karas.
Then choose 2 more days to do what you want, so I can get equally to our week.
Chadwick,
I'm
any preferences?
I'm going to go to the dwarven terra.
Could you repeat that?
How long would it take to actually get into one of the locked vaults?
Well, you need a key.
Oh, true. Yeah.
Question is what? Where's the keys?
That is a good.
Karas.
If you're gonna ask where the keys might be, Karen already asked, and he gave an answer that he doesn't know. Yeah. Remember how you got Terramok's key? It wasn't exactly easy peasy.
I was gonna say. I'm gonna go talk to the dwarf.
Mm-hmm.
And tell him I need special type of gun.
Hey.
What kind of gun?
I want some that are where the trigger is punching. More of a, with, it's like short range, I can punch, and that activates it, and then it's kind of like a big radius with a bunch of shrapnel around, getting shot instead of a bullet.
Oh my god, just say shotgun gauntlets.
Fair
enough.
Okay, let me roll a d20 for him. I wanna see. Let me see if he tries to figure out what you're putting down. Cause you're like, yeah, when he punch, he looks at you. When you punch, he kind of extends his both hands out and just starts doing like swinging the air, just like trying to figure out like when you punch,
I mean, I don't know much about guns, but I know when you pull the trigger, it something on top of it hits the bullet, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, what if instead of pulling a trigger, it's the force of a punch that activates the bullet?
Oh! He understands. In his brain, he all of a sudden clicked, but then his eyes are one of skepticism. And you're telling me you are capable of punching hard enough to trigger a bullet.
So we're in the forge, right?
Yes.
I am going to punch the wall.
Make a crater. Roll me a strength check. Not like the steel. Let's
just do the Farron and break a piece of steel in half.
That's Farron branded now. Britt has to do her own.
Let's see. 23.
Well, how do I say this? You punch, and the fucking air from the sounding air just, you know, spreads like a fucking gust as the brick that you hit essentially breaks in several pieces and crumbles. And it's not like a simple brick, it's like stone brick. You pull out your fist, you basically see that one stone is basically destroyed beyond repair. and the dwarf just whistles. Okay, fair point. And you want to punch. And then you wanna... He all of a sudden looks at you, grabs a piece of parchment from the table, and literally just grabs you by the hand, just kind of takes you to the table, and just tells you to place the hands on the paper.
Okay.
It takes about 5 minutes of him essentially making sketches of your arms in angles, in different angles, from the side, on your palms, on your, on the back of your palms.
By the way, do you make specialty magical effect bullets?
He shakes his head. No, we use plutonium. We're not savages.
Sorry.
Of course. That's only the most civilized people do.
He kind of looks at you.
We use radioactive weaponry.
Do you know what plutonium is?
I can't say that I do.
So you see, he's talking to you while he's making these sketches. He's very proficient.
She knows exactly what this is going to turn into as she says that. She knows, lecture time.
So, to put it pretty simply, Norn was a kingdom without magic. We had no comprehension of it. We had our guns and we used the best of it. You see, plutonium is like gunpowder, but about several thousand times stronger. Albeit, plutonium is not very healthy and is not exactly common like gunpowder. You cannot just make it out of other small components. But the kick it does extremely severe one. Albeit, if we use those bullets and it's attached to your arm, you're probably gonna be without an arm. Or your face. Or at least half of your body. When he says it, he stops drawing, just kind of pats you on the side and kind of checks your ribs. And maybe your ribs would be sticking out on some poor sob's face. Also, I don't have plutonium, so don't ask.
Thank the gods.
Good to know. By the way, Norn, I wouldn't happen to have been, heard a lot of exploits about a specific person from Norn, too.
Let me guess, Ken.
Yeah.
Engine,
Imp.
I remember the sod. Good fella, kind hearted. A bit of a reckless fella, but I mean, youth, you know? Continues drawing. I heard he made it upon himself the name, save the world and whatnot.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, we did at least a good deed for the world. Saved it, or I guess one of us did.
Then, kind of took over the mantle as the people of Norn, the god of Norn.
He's a god of many things, as I heard. He sometimes visits, us, or I guess visited. He's kind of busy with his own things, saving the world and whatnot. But every once in a while, I hear that he came by, said hi. Apparently, he has his own little secret place somewhere in the archipelago where he whisks people away. A rumor, mind you, I really don't know, and nor do I really care. But, people have been gone, and people were thinking, maybe we don't really belong in the coalition. Yeah, some people have found very good jobs and whatnot, but look at me. Master at arms, master gunsmith, but what, do I have to shovel coal until I fall over? No, I refuse.
Oh no, you must use the hands given to you to create.
Exactly, that's why I abandoned my comrades, Or I guess the banning each other, you know. Everybody will find the place. Anyway, I'm done. Okay. He pushes your... He essentially made your hands each left and right in 8 different angles. And he starts like doing a sketch. So, I don't know how this is gonna work, but give me some time and I'll figure something out. I understand what you're trying to do, but this is not exactly easy. It might be.
It is a worthy challenge, nonetheless, correct?
He nods.
Well, I have... If Arthur thinks you're cut up for the job enough to invite you all here, then I don't see why you wouldn't be up for it.
He just chuckles. Sure. Anyway... Anybody else has any cool, weird stuff you want to ask Runt? Any gun commissions?
Not a commission, but whenever I'm not busy during this week with either following Brit to deliver the ashes to the dwarves or actually enjoying some downtime with the cat, would they mind letting me look over their shoulder for a bit?
Oh yeah, pretty much very simply. Essentially, for the first week after, like at this point, the following week, I guess, they're gonna just be making, instructing, essentially prototypes on how one would stay on Chadwick. Like, that would stay in Chadwick, but also the gunner could stay on Chadwick as well. And, you know, a lot of stuff. But yeah, clearly you can just observe. You can be apprentice.
Would this be enough to attempt to start learning proficiency in smithing?
Yes.
What do I need yes.
to roll? You would roll 2d20s with advantage. Yeah.
You just perfectly cut out.
2d20s with advantage. So essentially, how do I say this?
Now my internet is dying again. Fuck.
Just roll a 2d20s. Yeah, 2 separate d20s, okay. But both of them with advantage.
Oh, sorry. That's the first one then?
Yeah.
So 14. And the other one.
Okay, good. I'll keep you up to your roll thing. So, okay. So, anybody else? Any commissions? Anything?
I finally remembered something I've been meaning to do for like 10 sessions.
Oh.
I need to go speak to Leo about my shield. My shield that I still haven't gotten identified.
You find... I'll give you the description because I don't have it by hand. But it's basically a nice, simple shield that is a +1.
A +1 shield.
Yeah, a +1 shield with bludgeoning resist. Bludgeoning
so
type
it gives damage. Me resistance to
the bludgeoning damage, or... yes. Yes, if you have it equipped.
Right.
Yes. So, said okay. First week,
and
at some point during the week, I'd like to send up a prayer to Trigmar. Just wishing for Farron's glory at his side, and making sure that he had a good transition to the afterlife, I suppose.
Despite wishing or asking confirmation that would ease your heart, no deliberate answer was given. You don't know if somebody heard it or not. You don't even need
Eric.
So, in that case, I just need to ask one simple thing then before, I guess, if everybody's good with their skipping of the week.
I do also want to talk with Runt.
Yes.
Because in the same breath that I remembered the shield, I came up with an idea.
I probably know what exactly gonna do. That give me a second. I want to find this.
Sergal would come to Runt with the shield. I've heard of I'm not really one for large weapons or things like that, I was curious. Would there be a could a gun like blind, like kind of shooting sand or small pellets? Yeah, kind of.
So you're asking if a gun could shoot sand?
I'm asking if there was like a way to like make a gun that blinds somebody effectively.
If you shoot them in the ice, you would blind them. That's Ron's answer, if you shoot them in the ice.
Fair enough.
A dead man also happens to be blind.
Would it be possible to add like a small like kind of widespread weapon to this shield, kind of sticking out from the inside, so I could block an attack and fire it in the?
Ooh, he looks at the shield. He the same way, literally grabs you. Like, pulls you to the table, grabs parchment, starts drawing, and let me see if he can figure this out. Does he give him a little reference? Oh shit, yeah. Not as insane as your other comrades, the thing to punch a bullet open. I could. See, and he gives you a quick, like, 5 minutes, like, but essentially instruction of how you would do it. Essentially, he would make a very small, a small imprint on the front of the shield, where he could load a bullets very primitively there, and he would make this makeshift lever that goes through the shield, where your arm would be holding the shield, and you basically would need to just pull with several fingers the lever to fire it.
That sounds about perfect for what I'm asking.
He just thinks of it. I mean, if you keep the shield here, maybe in the next week or after the centaur, I could do it in a day. Just, you know, like a finicking, a lot of parts, but a lot better than the what's her name, Brit, right? Brit, you have Brit, right?
Yes, Brit's our leader.
Yeah, she wants to punch fire, just stupid. But challenge is challenge.
Thank you.
So, any other weird and outlandish takes? Any other stuff?
Nah.
Speaking overall, apart from the smithing process, would the week be calm in regards to both the proceedings around Farron and the cat?
Well, first of all, would you try to go find? Because here's the thing, you know where Farron's family could be, like, but it's not exactly just around the block. This is a journey, right? So, question: do you would just go like try to go now, or would you go?
I would like to approach this journey the second Brit green lights it, because I was assuming that at least some of us would go, not just one person.
Yeah.
So when would Brit would like to do?
Well, I mean, there we did that.
If we do another week's time skip, how that would leave us with just one final week, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we could do that at the top of the final week.
Fair enough. Okay, so...
Well, that... I'm still doing my
Yes. I'll keep you then.
I just feel like a background character. Don't mind my insecurities.
Don't worry, eventually you will be more, but at the moment, yes, you are. So
don't worry, buddy. That's all of this.
Yeah. So I need a decision for 2 days that are left blank. What you want for upgrades?
Chadwick, do you have an idea or should we propose something?
Hey, you guys can't propose something. I'm getting my forge.
You're getting your forge to high heats?
Yeah.
As for the meantime, I can see
I got my Irie.
Yeah.
The aerial landing pad.
Should we see about getting the access to Hellforge? At least start that.
Britt, do you even have the documents of offerings open right now?
Well, I mean, I would imagine that it's equally equally famous forge master of some sort of godlike powers would be more than helpful in helping us procure.
If it's not in the options, it's not available. Maybe one day, but it's not available now.
Where is the file for these? Is it pinned?
Give me a second. I mean, it should be pinned, but I can see.
Ah, thank you, Electric.
I imagine going back to Death Row and searching out those crystals would take more than 2 days.
And that is still not something that Karrok is... Karrok may be doing this. This is a different story entirely. Given that we're talking about 2 days instead of four, there's only really a few different options. Granting privacy in, for example, showers, increasing the quality of the tables and chairs in the mess hall, increasing the capacity of beds, which we don't currently need, increasing the amount of pews, which we also currently don't need.
Brilliant.
And
brilliant
easily
thing that we need
increasing
done.
The quality of beds, which would be quite convenient.
Important thing that we need. Grant privacy for the showers and toilets. That takes 2 days. It's the perfect job.
So, Dad, then.
Please inform me. Has any of you or some, like, have we given it thought again about the fact that there's an entire crater of necrolite dirt?
That was what I believe Chadwick just mentioned.
Okay, I was just making sure.
Yeah.
So basically the week goes by, no problems, no troubles. You have a shit ton of lumber. The forge, after 5 days, Chadwick. Because the forge was artificially what at the beginning, but now that you have the dwarves that are smitting actively, it's always being kept by them. But then all of a sudden, in the middle of nowhere, you just hear a loud boom in the fifth day. And Karas informs gladly to all of you that the forge has been upgraded. And now reddish flames are subsided with this bright yellowish ones, and the heat is definitely significant. And this time, the source of the flame doesn't seem to diminish, nor does it require any alternative sources of fuel. So yeah, congratulations.
How are the eggs reacting to that?
The eggs are still in the same place, albeit a bit more warmer, perhaps, but nothing too bad.
Okay.
Yes. But yeah.
The entire party worrying about the eggs.
Yes. So, give me a second. So, for my boy Dagger. In terms of alchemy, you almost miraculously, almost like all the years of second like past words and opinions, formulas and methods almost translate to you as you essentially figure out basic recipes from your garden and from the surrounding areas, albeit weak, basic, simple, nothing that you actually are seeking. You do realize that if you want to find something, you know, significant, powerful, that, you know, because you're not gonna find like a bunch of goblins, you're gonna try to find demons, like big, strong, kind of very murderous demons, you should probably look for tomes, books, knowledge of alchemical formulas that, you know, have decades, centuries have been written.
Experience. I'm going into. To
Leo. Answer to everything.
Leo is the MVP of our group right now.
The rat wizard paid off so well.
The idiot that we rescued from a set of papers.
Yes. So, you would ask for...
He's still hiding at our place for tax fraud to the Platinum Seas.
So you would ask Leo, your resident wizard, for books on alchemy, essentially, right?
I want all the books you have. I don't care how dangerous. At this point, I'm throwing carefulness out the door. It's about success.
Okay,
it's about drive. It's about power.
Shut up.
He literally looks at you to your almost like shout and just says, okay. And literally within the next 2 minutes presents with you 8 tomes. Dorian Herbalatory Encyclopedium volumes 1-5 and Dorian Alchemy Encyclopedium volumes 1-3. It's about 4,000 pages of stuff in all 8 tomes, and you have about 100 pounds of books now. Happy reading!
One last request.
He does not. He poops out.
I'm gonna start setting myself up to read, and I'm gonna be skipping a few lunches.
I mean, question, are you gonna look, are you just gonna try to learn everything, or are you looking for specific? Because it's not like
I am going to look in specific if I can find a way to gain a permanent version of my ancestors, like ancestral strength. Like, I'm going back to giant sicko mode. I want to have this. I want
He's
to
making
go back
the
to giant
formula.
I want the power of a titan to help my brothers.
Oh my god!
I want to be the force that holds the balance of the worlds in the palm of my hand.
The power of the gods in the palm of my hand.
I don't care if I fail, I'll die trying. This time.
Oh.
I'm not taking my time.
Oh god, okay. So. Okay, that's your culmination for the second week. So. For Nathan, you have 2 paths to take. Because smitting is a broad term, right? Because even in Dorian types, you have different aspects of smitting. Armor smithing, jewel smithing, weapon smithing. Here, however, there is nothing like that. You have 2 types of smithing you can pursue here. One of gunsmithing or one of engineering. Something, when it comes to engineering, it would be something akin to Artificer, but more primitive. by all means, because magic. Yes, for magic is not included.
So oddifies for fun of magic.
Exactly. The path.
I don't know why, but that sounds weird to say. That magicless engineering is primitive.
No. Magicless artificer is engineering.
If you try to compare it to artifice, it is primitive.
Yes.
Because
fair enough.
Artifice measures enough. It based on the applicability of magic, but this doesn't have any.
So you have simple two things. Path of engineering or path of gunsmithing?
I like the idea of the blind gunslinger, so...
gunsmithing.
Gunsmithing it is.
Okay. Can you roll me 3d100s? Oh my god.
91 and 92. So,
the sheer amount of terminology, motives, everything. You're essentially in a large smeltery of gold nuggets of wisdom and knowledge when it comes to the term. You are in the presence of one of the best in the world. And every single comment thrown away from your keen ears is unparalleled insight in the aspects of gunsmithing. You, without a doubt, but a bit of elbow grease and inspiration, can manage to do basic guns. Guns, gunpowder, traps, fragmentation grenades. As long as you have the time, the material, and the position. So, were you willing to ride some stuff? Could you?
Sorry, what?
Could you write some stuff down, Nathan?
Right now?
Yes. Because you have some recipes that you learned.
Okay.
Okay.
Ready?
So, you learn how to make gunsmithing tools, which is just a different type of smithing tool.
Okay.
You have advantage on performance checks when you're making a gun. You can make short range gun, parenthesis shotgun. You can make medium range gun, parenthesis submachine gun. And yeah. A long ranged rifle, in parenthesis bolt action rifle. And fragmentation grenade.
In parentheses, fragmentation.
One question.
Yes.
What's the stance on revolvers?
Revolvers is with the. Technically, revolvers would go with the short thing. It would be considered. That's good for you. So, and I've been just playing one soundtrack this entire fucking 2 hours. That's pretty fucking.
So be it.
It is what it is. Okay. So, Chadwick, my boy. Oh yeah, I just need to say something. Nothing has really transpired. Everything is good. Everything is peaceful. Nobody died. And everybody's kind of just living in, you know? Everybody's just kind of accepted they're just gonna live now. Even Elena, kind of chilling, minding her business. Not really talking to any of you, just kind of there. So, Chadwick, the day has come for Runt to call you and the rest. But my main focus is on you. And Nora. For... How do I say this? I need to find the image. Get a fucking about it. So, what you basically have... what you're basically presented to is a tube, a black metal tube that is like a metallic barrel, where it just looks like, you know, pretty fancy looking barrel, and there's a bunch of harnesses that you need to put on. They're kind of elevated, and you are told to essentially sit down as people are gonna put the thing in.
All right, I'll get prepared for this.
Yeah. So you do position yourself, and then as you kind of, despite how the barrel looks, it doesn't really feel even as, like, it's not even as heavy as Farron was on your back. It was a lot heavier. And then Nora is told to basically get on it, or I guess in the barrel. She gets on the barrel, and you hear a bunch of sounds of buzzing, sharp turns, as from everybody else's perspective, Nora somehow is spinning rapidly in the barrel. Not like super hard, but like turning left and right until eventually she kind of bounces out. Just kind of looks a bit confused at what's going on.
Why am I just imagining going...
Kind of.
You know what I'm imagining? Teacup rides.
Kind of. Imagine just a black barrel, almost, that has like a side entrance. That is placed on a centaur, and now just you see, basically, the red dragonborn's head and shoulders just peeking out from it. As Run just asks, so how does it feel? How do you, for both of you, technically? He kind of looks at you, Chadwick. You don't really feel bad.
I'll kind of shift back and forth a little bit, see how it shifts on my back. Yeah, so it's pretty good.
A little bit of distance to counteract your swaying, so it doesn't just fall off to the ground or get hit by a tree. What about you? Nora just kind of looks a bit confused. I mean, this is weird, but what's the point of this? Oh yeah, and he just whistles and says, "Lads, give her the point." So you didn't notice until you were you got acknowledged by it. There's just a small piece, like a cloth, draped over just the bundle of steel that was procured, and as it is uncovered, you see a large, very large gun. To put in perspective, this gun is larger than Farron. The bullets are bigger than your fingers, and it takes three of the engineers to essentially grab it and just slowly but surely put it on the top of the frame as it snaps in nicely and begins to just move with Nora as she moves around. Mind you, there is no ammo in it.
No ammo?
No ammo. Run just looks at you and says, no ammo. You don't want her to misfire into your head now, do you?
Good point. But
I don't know.
Where is the ammo? We kind of want to try this out.
Okay, outside. So, Chadwick, can you roll me? Ooh, there's no roll in 5e for this, so let's roll a d20.
Just a d20?
Yeah.
Roll a gun check.
No, it would be an adaptability check, but it is not a thing. Oh my fucking god! Holy shit! You literally flinch for like 2 seconds as you feel not really confident, and then everything just sinks in. You and the tube are one. It is the extent of you. As you literally make your way down to the first floor, and now everybody can see you, the black tube, and the red dragonborn in it. Holding to whatever she can, but also the fucking gun that is attached to it. So I assume everybody...
You have to know, Chadwick, that looks comical on top of it.
It doesn't feel all that comical. Shoot it!
The ammo gets loaded. And after a simple instruction on how to shoot it, Nora literally starts, just clicks, and you see the tree line that she shoots. All of a sudden, the massive tree branches that get whizzed and hit, the branches that get hit almost explode into just twigs and just sawdust. When it hits a trunk of a bigger tree, there's loud cracking sounds as if an axe hit them deep. After a burst of 50 bullets, about 7 trees are at the brink of collapsing. 2 of them collapse, and just a section of a tree line looks a lot more uglier.
That's not going to grow back fast.
Yeah, it feels about right. This is Farron's legacy.
Is that how we're gonna call it? The Farron, then?
Oh, no.
I don't know. I thought the Farron's legacy actually sounded like quite a good...
you decide. Well, our job is then. Our job is here, it's done. So, you can figure out the name. Of course, you will need bullets, and we can provide it to you, but, mind you, it's not bendable. It's not flammable, but you will sink deeply with this if you go into water. Just taps you on the side, Chadwick. And just kind of leaves back into the place. And you're basically left now with this giant tube on your back and Nora on top of the tube with a gun.
What is Nora's reaction to the firing of the gun?
Passive perception, insight for everybody. You see a smile and this untold satisfaction and seeping bloodlust in her eyes.
Well, this isn't dangerous in the slightest.
This is
hey,
not
how about
going
this
to
one?
Bad.
I don't feel safe.
Don't worry, I'll just learn how to block bullets.
Don't worry, I just learned to dodge.
Well, yeah, we're learning to become more powerful than demigod. Might as well. What if one of them has a
gun? It's a machine gun! Smiles.
Wait a minute. Which gods are immune to bullets?
It is.
Say that out loud, and most of them will answer with a lightning strike to your face.
It is not non-magical piercing damage, so a lot of them.
Yeah, I'm not there. I'm busy.
Wait a second. I gotta ask this question. Does Dagger have reading glasses?
He has broken reading glasses, so basically a monocle.
Oh no.
Ah. Because I just love the idea of you just sitting there studying those old tomes with like either a monocle or reading glasses.
I has bullet damage, sheepy. Anyway, second week is done. You got your little thing. Very congratulations, Chadwick. You now found use for Nora.
You found a use.
Oh, she's already been way well useful.
I found another use for Nora.
Exactly. So second week is done, essentially. And now the third and the final week should begin. So what would you like to do through the third week?
I got my gun shield, right? Because I didn't.
No, it just finished the thing with Chadwick, and now it should begin.
There's a queue.
Every minute of every hour, I will be continuing my quest.
Yes, I know, Dagger.
I feel like I have to. Never mind. I'll just shut up. Then.
If Dagger ever does take a break, Sergo will be pestering him to spar.
Not now, boy. I'm trying to find a way to gain strength.
Not that boy. Boy.
And you think I'm not? Practical experience means just as much as your books.
Fair, but these books will allow me something greater than just martial prowess.
So...
What's the point of it if you can't use it?
Unless you can find a way to infuse the knowledge in my brain directly, I doubt I'll have the time.
Listen, Dagger, size doesn't matter. It's how you use it.
I'm looking for the strength, not necessarily the size, but might as well. I'm looking into the matters of ancestry, and mine is of giants. So please, let me up my studies.
I said whenever you take a break, not in the middle of your
It's just your excuse to get back to studying.
Yes, exactly.
I wanted to take a rest, but this guy's been pestering me, so I'm using this as a motivation to get back into it.
So week three, people, what would you like to do? Also decide what you want for the week's upgrades.
Got anything that takes a week?
Flat week?
Nothing that takes.
We all want some tasty meals. We can upgrade the kitchen.
Is reading myself to the bone a valid statement?
Well, yeah, your fingers can get the score.
Mm. Paper cuts all the way. Getting slashing resistance just from getting paper cuts enough.
So, while the week, you decide the week choices, what does everybody would like to do for a week? Again, I'm trying to look for Farron's family.
Man, you are cutting out a lot more.
We are top of the week. We're going for whoever wants to join. We are going to go and give Farron's family the news. We will probably give them a day to prepare once the news is spread to them, if they so choose to be part of the ceremony.
Good news, everyone! Your relative's dead!
Finally!
So, question. how many of you will be going? Because technically, Karis knows where they are, and Leo can be given information by Karis, so Leo can take you there. How many of you are going?
I feel like it's necessary for me to go.
Sure.
I think Sergal would probably go.
Come on, come on. Who's going with
you? I will join as well.
Dagger, you?
Nope. Still busy. Not resting till I achieve my goal.
So,
enlightenment.
Sleep is for the weak.
Since Leo is necessary for your teleport, who else would you bring from the companion? Anyone?
Leo, definitely. Nora, if she's interested. I mean, it's kind of an ass move to show up to, like, who's this girl? Yeah, she's the replacement of your son.
Well,
don't
Nora,
say that.
Nora
don't
wouldn't really
know,
but still. She's willing. She will go if you ask.
She's not short enough to replace Farron.
Oh, God.
Very not truly.
So, everybody goes except for Dagger and no one of the companions, is that correct?
Pretty much.
Okay. Well, in that case, I'm gonna change the music. I kinda wanna do this music. Will not fit. Will fit better. Okay, let's... Thank you, Bob, but let's skip the tune to something more cold. Oh! Yes. So, my good people. Better. There you go. So, somewhere on the first day of your third week, you, of course, because Karis knows exactly where of his siblings to live, including his mother, and with the help of Leo and his teleportation capabilities and the cooperation between the two, all of you except for Dagger teleport somewhere higher than you've ever been, except for Nathan. You've been fucking high as a oof, but somewhere a lot more colder than you've ever been. As I, you know what, I'm gonna be a nice guy. One of you roll me a d100.
A d what?
A d100, one of you.
Chadwick.
Gonna put it all on Chadwick.
34.
34. Okay. 54. Oh, 54. So, eeny, meeny, miny, moe, catch the bird toe. Chadwick, roll me a d6. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So, the first sensation that you all feel is cold. High altitude and pressure in your head as you all land in a street covered in snow. Basically, about 2 feet of your body is very fresh, pure, pale white snow, and you're getting colder as seconds pass by. Sergal, however.
Yes.
Yes, Sergo. You all of a sudden plop. Not. Oh god. Did the music bot just die? My Discord died. Hold up. Why did my Discord die? Hello? Hold on a second. I'm getting this. The Discord. Boop. Give me a second. Ooh. I'm yet alone again. Come on. Did my Discord actually just die? Oh, nope. Come on, load it.
Is the DM still alive?
Are you there?
Yes, hello.
Circle just plop in what?
Yeah, give me a second. Hold up. I just want to make sure that everything is in order. Oh, God.
Just the fact that you just stopped that plop just had us all confused.
Your entire stream just died.
They set you
on. Is the stream dead? Yeah. Oh, yeah, all the right pictures now. Are dead.
Give me a second. I'm gonna quickly.
We've all turned crashes, into mountains.
You're all. Oh! There you go.
Fitting for what I'm doing, but I don't know about you guys.
Yeah. So, Circle, you plopped into a warm house at the very corner of it. You look around. And you see this very nice, a very well-furnished house, with furs, with a warm fireplace, and can you just roll me a perception? Gonna look for this, there you go. Fifteen. Well, definitely they're not hiding. Second.
You said perception.
I shall. Ooh. Good. Okay. So, what you can clearly see. Is somebody has been making probably breakfast or dinner, but they're not here. They're somewhere. As for everybody else outside in the street, you're in the middle of a street. It is quite dark because it's morning. You don't see anybody. You see a bunch of still flickering torches by some walls. But you also see that Sergal is nowhere to be seen.
Yeah.
Sergal? Yes. As you look around, immediately you hear huffled voices through the wall calling out your name.
Do I happen to see a front door?
You look and you do find it basically on the other side of this house. It's not a big house, it's like 30 by 30.
Do I hear anybody else inside of the house?
No. You see that there was breakfast being prepared, but there's no one at the moment here.
I am going to make sure none of my things like fell off.
Yeah.
Fell away from me, and I am going to quickly slip out the front door.
Can you roll me a sleight of hand check?
Are you sure that is in fact the door?
Oh no, it's not the door. As he like approached the door and tried to get out of the back door, how do I say this? You all of a sudden, as you reach for the door, in front of the door, immediately from your fucking right, a bright steel axe swirls past you and hits the door in front of you. As all of you from the outside, you're looking confusion, hear a voice quite loudly, almost yelling, by the one that you are. Sergal, you see a dwarven woman, in her 40s, 50s by the looks, still a bit charcoal black, bit ashen hair. You almost feel a familiar aura by just staring at this woman as she readies up another fucking hatchet and asks, "So, ready to steal something more, thief?"
Sergal kind of like blinks, confused. No, I just came here. There seems to have been a teleportation mishap.
What is everybody else doing?
Question, does the door swing towards her or towards me?
Towards you. She has a clear... She is ready to throw. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, well, if she's throwing, I'm fine. I'm going to, like, swing open the door. Is her axe still embedded in it?
Yes, it is.
Well, then I'm trying to yank the axe out of her hand with the door.
Oh, no. She threw it from a distance, like 10 feet.
I'm opening the door, and I am just pointing outside to the rest of the party, like,
you didn't listen. She has another axe in her hand. She's ready to throw if you're going to do any sudden moves. You want to risk it? Yeah, you want to risk it? I don't think she can hit you. I mean, she could.
Well, she could, yes.
Also, what is everybody else doing?
Frankly,
come on, Sergal, underestimate the lady.
I want to de-escalate. Yeah, you definitely. I do not want to escalate. I came here to visit a family of one of my friends. You don't happen to be the mother of a Farron, do you? Familiar auras.
Man. But yeah, you can hear the muffled yell from the house that you literally teleported by. It's up to you if you wanna see if you can find a way to get in. Because from where you teleported, there is not exactly a way in.
Just encircling the house. Yeah, I'll circle around to the
left and look.
If you look around, like you go around the house, you do find a stone door that leads inside.
Currently, the blade of an axe poking out of one end.
not that deep enough, sadly.
Big old knock on the door.
Sergal, can you roll me performance or a persuasion?
No, it's too late. Performance is
as a
my
knock.
Thing.
Jesus Christ. Okay, 22.
It's the one thing I have double digits. No, I have double digits in intimidation.
Sedation, you say?
So all of a sudden, you, Sergal, you hear a knock by the door that you tried to open. Sergal, what do you want to say as you knocked?
Circle, are you in there?
You can hear.
Ah, that must be my friends. And I open the door with me behind the door in case she throws again.
No, she...
Or is she lowering her axe?
No, she's not lowering. She just looks conflicted. Of course, when you open the door, you can clearly see Brett and everybody else.
Is it open in a way I can see the axe in the door?
No.
Oh, wait, no. It's on my side.
Discord yeah. Line again. It is.
Well, no, because he said he's opening the door.
NP, we hear you.
No, it's stuck from the inside, and he opens. The door goes in inside. Not outside.
Okay, so it goes inwards. So we don't see it. Okay,
yeah, you don't.
That's what I was trying to get at.
As you open the door, and you know, I don't know if you're gonna go in or not. The lady almost screams, says, "I'm sorry, it doesn't say that." Basically, almost screaming, "What do you know of my son?"
He was one of our party.
He was my best friend for quite a while.
She eyes each and every one of you as she twirls in her right hand one of the hand axes. My son died. Wandered off into the cold wastes. You're telling me he's alive.
Was. Up until about a week ago, give or take. And I'll slowly reach back for the jar.
And I'll slowly, like, pry the silvered axe that got thrown at me out of the door and just
set it down on a table. So bad.
Sergal, you still have the drinking can, right?
I think so, yes.
I suggest you take a seat. If there are any other family members within your domicile, recommend they come down to hear about
no,
this.
No, they're not. How? What do you mean he lived? Do you tell me? Are you here to tell me that the paladin lied to me? Taken by the coal, eaten by beasts, nothing but scraps of clothing remaining. Is that what you're gonna tell me? That he lied?
Yes. Sergal just looks annoyed at the mere mention that the paladin lied.
We know exactly which paladin she's talking about.
We know exactly which paladin she's talking about.
You can clearly see that whatever Farron zealotry, eagerness, the whole conquest aspect, it came from her. She's swirling that fucking hand. She's ready to go down.
Please, if you would just... If we do have the full story of what happened, we're
okay,
sorry.
Okay, spill it out then.
So, yes. You unfortunately were lied to about him not surviving. He's been living... With the paladins, with us, ever since then. As of recently, we were relocated from Tanis after it was destroyed, and us surviving. It wasn't recently until recently. The right the questions were asked, and more or less, he's no longer with us. He turned to ash and ascended.
She flinched her face a bit when you say Tannis. Tannis. Like Tannis near Olash? Across the fucking... Do you even know where you are? How did you get in?
Precisely.
Leo just randomly walks in, just like, kind of gives away. Teleportation, madame. Leo at your service, by the way. And immediately he sees the axe twirling and just ducks back into the thing.
She throws another axe?
No, she doesn't, but when Leo sees that there's an axe in her hand twirling and she just gives a gaze, he fucking goes back into the streets like, yeah.
you can deal with the crazy axe.
As she kind of points her axe towards the door and just kind of gives this motion for all of you to come in. Okay, come in, close the fucking door.
Right.
We will head inside.
My dead son may be dead now, but I'm still alive and I'm not gonna die from fucking cold.
Wait, could you repeat that sentence, please?
She doesn't want to die from cold.
Yeah, she... Even though her dead son is now really dead.
Okay, thank God.
What?
The connection was just really bad. So I didn't hear my dead son, my dad's son.
Oh. No.
Which has horrible implications.
Yes, no.
God. No.
Yeah, she basically tells you all to go come in and close the fucking door. Because you're fucking.
Yep. We be doing that. Again, I want to apologize for such short notice. We've, been coming terms to it with it
she,
personally since the incident.
Brit, she looks at you. She does not give a shit. Passive insight dictates she fought all these years. Her son was dead. Now you tell her that her son wasn't dead, but is now dead. So in her eyes, nothing has changed. And your condolences are not ones that she will take lightly, but more as an insult. She is the Frodo Theron, through and through.
Yeah. You'll be happy to know that he fought with such fire and ferocity that you're worthy of tales. Like, I saw him go head on with a giant basilisk. No fear. I can see where he gets that ferocity now.
Kind of takes a sigh.
Well, he was one hell of a craftsman.
At least he didn't brought shame. That's at least good to hear.
He brought far more than shame.
No.
Far more than shame. He brought. Hold on. You didn't let me finish the sentence, right? You brought glory upon our group and your family. He was truly a warrior among warriors.
Sometimes I can still feel his ghost watching over us. Oh, hey!
the ghost of Baron, who would have thunk. So, did he have any belongings or whatnot?
He... I mean, we have...
He took it with him.
Oh, you go ahead, Chadwick.
Along with the ashes that I'm putting on the table, I'll reach back and find the last will that he had for his mother.
God. Baron, I know you're here, so you're gonna read it out? Because I don't have the will. I don't know what is written in it.
Do it!
Give me give me a second. Let me do something. I'm gonna... Oh, wait. I deleted your head. Uh-oh. Okay, never mind.
There wow. Is
no
wow.
Head.
No faith. No faith.
There is no written version of that particular will. The only proper written will was the one to the party.
Okay, what impromptu then? What would you write to your mother that you never met ever since Terramok took you in? Or your family, or whatever.
Oh, hi, Mom. I decided not to come back after he lied.
All right. Impromptu. Is she like? Is she just reading this out loud? Is she reading this to herself?
She will read this out loud.
Damn it.
Come on.
I find it funny that you were not prepared for this eventuality of reading that fucking will.
Not to you guys.
Oh, really?
Who would have brought it?
All right, then. I know the summary of this one. Don't hash too hard over some fumbled words here. Hello, Ma. Pa. It's been a while. Been busy.
That's it.
the will ends there. It's like...
Is that it?
No. Please, don't take it seriously.
Okay, you know what's the best part?
I'm scared.
When she reads Pa, she just kind of like... She kind of scoffs.
Spits into a corner.
Yeah, literally.
I've been busy for a while. Only just recently got some tabs on you. Hope I got the chance to visit. Anyways. Sorry. I guess I have some catching up to do. So. Let me get on with it. I was found a while ago. Got lost in the mountains, as you probably know. Didn't die. That was surprising. And Tarmac picked me up.
Okay, you don't need to say anything more. So first of all, when you said, I hope you visited, you know, I visited you, she looks at the jar and then continues on. And when you say Tarmac, immediately she rips the... What remained of your will and chucked it into the fire. And then looked at you, Brit, and asked, where is he?
I assume you mean Tara.
There was actually something you guys might have would have heard in there. Alright, we're gonna shut up.
Yeah, but the thing is, we know he's on this plane, but exactly where, we're still trying to figure that one out.
Are you gonna
we have
meet
a lot
him?
Of
planning eventually. On it?
Eventually.
Well, I'm going with you then. I'm not taking a no for an answer. I'm going with you.
I'm pretty sure nobody was going to think of saying no to Farron's
well,
mother.
We're definitely not going to say no.
Okay, so
imagine that you have a few choice words and actions to for Tarmac, as we do as well.
Out of character, can I just tell you guys a little something?
Mm. So, is it important to the session?
Kind of. Are you gonna make this very angry mother meet with Inca, who also wants a peace?
Oh, I mean,
we're
not gonna. This is an angry mama bear. We ain't gonna say no to this.
This is
Farron's family mama bear.
This is what made Farron. I need to imply this. This is what made Farron.
Yeah, this is literally as you said, proto Farron.
Oh,
yeah. we would be
absolutely get the shit beat out of us if we didn't say yes.
Screw the mythic levels, you're fucked if you say no.
No, no.
I don't think, I, no would, theory, would like, any of us want to say no? Because like, fair, sure, no sure, theory, he's, sure, Tarmac is working for the greater good, but he's kind of been a wad on the way.
I mean, he needs to have his shit kicked in, that's for sure. Ain't no amount of greater good that's gonna fix mother being lied to about the death of their child.
In any sense, yeah. It's like, Well, I'm not one to deny somebody that chance. We're more than honored to welcome you into the group.
She immediately goes, grabs the hand dex from her thing from the wall. Looks around.
I pulled it out and set it down on a table, just like carefully.
She all of a sudden, there's like a handful of like tools, like a crowbar, a few shovels, you know, just like basic stuff by the fire. But she grabs the crowbar, goes to a corner, and just starts hitting the fucking floor. All of a sudden, you hear a loud crack. There lies a chest, and there lies full set of mithril plates, a mithril scimitar, a mithril shield with a depiction of a bull. A bow made of blackish wooden material, silver arrows, and a whistle of an owl. Literally. Oh boy.
She is the one you called to kill the Boogerman.
Okay, yeah, and now
she's the one you sent to and kill then, the ancient white dragon.
And she looks around, like she turns back, looks at you, Nate, points at you, and says, "You blind one, go out to the next building, knock on the door, and tell that I'll be going for a while to keep on the house."
Okay.
Could we get a name? I'm Sergal, by the way.
Name's Vorica.
Nice.
Vorica?
Yes.
Can you spell that?
I have many titles, none of them matter. What matters is what I'm gonna do.
You're named now Baba Yaga.
Baba, yeah.
Whether you want to or not.
But yeah, and yeah, the man in question, Exor, is your go.
I will.
Yeah, you literally find like literally opposite the street, a few feet away, another door. Mm-hmm. You knock in, you meet an older dwarf, 70s. Yeah, he's Yorick. You give a quick TLDR, and Ulrika equips herself slowly but surely, literally dresses in front of you, and just gets herself in full fucking mithril.
I saw her kill three Baelors with a pencil.
Can anybody get okay? Roll me a religion or a history, because the armor is very like high quality but basic. The only thing that has any significance is the.
Trying my luck with history.
Why do I have a feeling that this one was an old paladin?
Roll with advantage.
Oh yes. Nathan! Is that a religion?
That was history.
History. Oh my god! There is an ancient sect of the paladins in the Dwarven Kingdoms called the Banes of Bahamut. For the sole reason that they once upon a time repel invasion from demonic prince of Bahamut and their minotaur armies. Mithril signifies one of the highest honors of the paladins in that order. and they're in few numbers. Mainly to be fought, mythos, and extinct. They are master demonologists and interrogators. And the shield in question, Eren, actually potentially has the power to subjugate all minotaurs or children of Bahamut within the vicinity. Bahamut.
I don't know why I love the irony of subjugating a giant bull with a mirror.
Farron was the runt of the family.
Runt is actually now a pretty proficient title, so.
Oh my god.
I get it, because he was short.
if Farron was here.
That's an interesting question, real quick. Like, compared to Farron himself, how does Vorica like measure up? Like, is she taller or is she shorter?
She is slightly taller.
Wait a minute.
Farron was stronger.
Hey, so the guy named Rund, was he smaller or was he just average dwarf size?
Oh, Rund?
Was he actually smaller?
No. I think Farron was 3'8", right? Come on, Farron.
Okay, so before.
Wait a second, I can look that up for you.
Vorica is 4'2".
Damn.
Yeah.
Average woman height.
Bro. Canceled.
Can't you say that?
Hey, listen. Listen, I know a few people.
His height isn't
and they're coming towards
I'm just
location.
Gonna say it's I'm gonna leave it ambiguous. I have the number in front of me. I'm gonna leave it ambiguous just because I like the idea of each time you remember Farron, you remember him shorter than the last time.
What do you mean? Every time we met Farron, he was shorter than the last time.
You know, mostly because of crippling injuries, but
you know I can just look at your character sheet. Yep, right.
You can.
Let's see. We know exactly the canonical height of Farron. Give me a second.
He never wrote it in.
He also grew shorter with every mythic level.
Wait. He was what?
4'5".
So taller than his mother.
Yeah, taller. And I forgot.
Wow.
Proof that. Okay. Proof that his mother is stronger.
Still punting size.
Wasn't there an argument at some point that Farron, in some rare cases, pretended to be 4'5", but in reality was like 4'9" or something?
No, let's not mix it up.
No,
anyway.
You got her essentially equipping Mithra and now saying, so, where are we going? Because I'm not leaving without you.
We are going to, our place of residence. You'll love it. Farron actually, won it in a test of strength and ferocity for us.
Oh, is that so?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's see what backwater dwelling have you received. Waiting. You kind of looks.
All right, Leo? Leo, are you still outside?
Yeah, he is in the street. He's peering out. He is terrified.
Right.
Reasonably so.
But we got
you can come in now, it's safe.
Leo, it's time to have work or we are all gonna die.
He kinda looks, right? And it's like, okay, just a home, right? Yes, we're going back to the hold.
Yes.
Oh yeah, one more thing. Vorica, before actually begins to go, she looks around, grabs the pot of ashes, and chucks it into the flames.
Oh boy! Ah yet, and one more thing!
Nathan sighs for a few seconds.
Anyway.
But then just continues on anyway.
I mean, I think dwarves bury their dead whole. I don't think they incinerate them. So.
He's already been in ashes.
Remember.
He can't really do much worse.
So
we have to
honestly
be scared. This mother created Farron, so whatever she does in regards to training regime with us now, we're fucked.
Oh boy.
Both of you two assume that Sergal wants
to do
it sometimes harder.
When she undressed, man. How many of you stared at her? Or just
none.
Didn't she send me off to do something?
Yeah.
I definitely didn't.
Aaron's mom has got it going on.
Yeah, I'm, I don't know. It's just like, you know.
I guess then, Britt, you can roll me a medical check.
Who looked at the scars?
Who looked at the medical
scars?
Chick?
Medical
check. Didn't even do one of those.
Because there's something. There
actually,
was something. There was something clearly on her back. Was kind of off.
That is a wisdom check, so.
It's a big heart. It's a big heart tattoo with the captions "I love my hubby," except it's crossed out with tattooing.
All right, here we go with the guidance.
Oh God! You look at her back for a glimpse to see, and you realize that in her back, we see when something hot. Like a rod or even a knife, is etched out and scarred demonic runes. What they can entail, you do not know demonic, do you? Or infernal. Actually, abyssal?
Abyssal?
You have
no, listened. I only know celestial.
Yeah, you just know there's some fucking edgy fucking runes on her back.
I'll just remember the runes and see if anybody else knows it, knows the language.
I'll just remember.
I'm gonna scribble it down when she's not looking.
I can just imagine you just drawing Farron's mom from the back, bareback.
You draw me like one of the dwarf girls.
Draw me like one of your dwarf girls.
No. Draw me like one of your forge girls.
Oh, God.
Shut up.
So, all of you teleport back home. Back home to the hold. And 2 weeks have gone by, and now I have 1 week. Oh, my fucking God. Well, it's been 3 hours. I think we can call it here.
I think it is.
Very gladly.
Wow.
You met with Farron's mom.
The line for punching Taramak grows longer.
Farron,
wasn't that good.
Farron, I'm just gonna say this. If you were alive and you met her, and you're like, yeah, I just ventured to say hi, she would have kicked the living shit out of you because you didn't came sooner.
I'm very aware of that.
The image for this is
pull in there, buddy.
You Farron, got away easy.
It's quite easy, actually, Farron. If you wouldn't have arrived at her doorstep dead, she would have made you dead.
Exactly.
You got away easy.
Return on a shield or don't return.
So that's the real reason he turned to ash and went to become a god. He didn't want to go see his mother.
Get away from his mother. His mother, meanwhile, researching how to become divinity.
Oh my God! I just realized you literally, like, Evren, you have the fucking dad who's like fucking stares at you. As Farron, you have the mom.
Why can't I just have normal parents? Why don't you just build normal characters, they say.
Anyway, so anything you want to say before I'm shutting this stream? No survivors. Go.
Smite!
Smite!
Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite! Smite